Hello friends, I am Dr. Swinder Singh from Punjab University, Chandigarh. I'll be talking about, in continuation with the earlier topic on Municipal Corporation, we'll talk about Mayor and Commissioner, their position and role in the Municipal Corporation. As we discussed earlier, a corporation has three main wings. One is deliberative wing, another is executive wing, and third is the committee system in a municipal corporation. Mayor is the head of the deliberative wing, whereas municipal commissioner is the head of executive wing. Both of them play a very important role in the working of a corporation. As far as mayor is concerned, he is the leader of the council, and the council, as we know, is the body of elected councillors. There may be 50 or there may be 150 councillors depending upon the size of the corporation, and mayor is the head of that council, and he enjoys very important and significant position in the city. There are different patterns as far as his appointment is concerned, as far as his election is concerned. In most of the states, he is elected indirectly, that is by the councillors. And its term also varies from state to state. In some states, it is just 1 year. In some other states, it is two years and 2.5 years. There is also a discussion whether a mayor should be directly elected or he should be indirectly elected. A directly elected mayor will enjoy more powers, but there may be some political problems, as he may not be just a simple head of the council, but he is likely to have clashes with other elected leaders like MLAs and MPs. So in most of these cases, he is indirectly elected by the council members. Now he enjoys certain powers. First and foremost is he is the presiding officer of the council. He presides over the meetings. He participates in the discussions and deliberations of the council, and he plays important role as far as his contribution to a particular matter is concerned. Then he has certain ceremonial powers in the city. Other than his participation in the council, in the city he performs certain ceremonial formalities, certain social functions, certain inaugurations or participation in other meetings, receiving of certain dignitaries in the city and all that. Apart from this, he also participates in, he also enjoys some executive powers. In some states, he has been given power as far as appointment of certain officials are concerned. Moreover, he has access to the municipal records. He can inspect the work of the corporation, and he can assess, he has the power to assess the records. He can make inspections, he can make supervisions, he can issue certain directions, and it depends upon his personality, his capability, that how far he is effective as far as the works or his supervision of the works is concerned. As far as the commissioner is concerned, he is the head of the executive wing, and executive wing is another important part of the municipal corporation, because corporation has a number of functions, and it is the commissioner who is the head of the executive wing. But before his functions as executive head, we can also discuss some of his functions which are in relation to legislative aspects, that is his functions in relation to council. In fact, certain proposals or certain resolutions which are to be passed by the council, those resolutions, they pass through commissioner. Rather, proposals pass go through the commissioner, and he may modify those resolutions or those proposals. And while having discussion on the resolutions, he may give his inputs, he may supply some information, he may give his experts' comments as far as those resolutions are concerned. Although it is for the council to decide whether to accept those proposals or not, it is for the council. Therefore, he can contribute positively as far as the working of the council is concerned. Secondly, his administrative functions or executive functions, which are very important. He being the head of the executive wing, whatever functions a municipal corporation is performing, whatever executive functions or whatever projects or routine functions of the corporations are concerned, he plays very important role in that. He may inspect, he may supervise, he may direct the operations and working of the all the works of the municipal corporation. Along with these functions, he has financial functions. Every municipal corporation has a big budget, and those budgets are to be framed by the executive wing of the municipal corporation. It is not a simple budget, because there is a budgeting is something very important in which resources are to be matched with the demands, and every city has more and more demands, more and more requirements. As far as finances are concerned, those finances are limited, and it is up to the management or financial skills of the municipal corporation that how he allocates those minimum or limited resources to meet the maximum demands of the people or the requirement of the city. So, first one is the budgeting. He plays important role in budgeting. Secondly, within the budget, there is a provision of taxation or raising of certain new resources. It may be collection of certain fees, it may be levying of new taxes, it may be introduction of certain fees in order to raise the income of the municipal corporation. It is all up to the municipal commissioner to propose that particular budget and take it to the council. And there, again, it is his skill that how far he is able to convince the council and the members and the mayor to pass those proposals. Thereafter, important issue is when we discuss about the mayor and the commissioner, important part is how far their relations go, because one is mayor is the head of the council, the deliberative wing, and the municipal commissioner is the head of the executive wing. Both have very important role to play. And some of the studies have shown that wherever their relations are cordial and both of them have positive attitude towards the development of the city, people have found wonders. They have found that the city has grown in a very decent manner. But wherever their relations are not good, their relations are not good because it is a fight between two heads, then the city suffers and the people suffer. So, their relations have to be cordial, and there may be certain factors, there may be certain personality issues, or there may be certain level of understanding between the two which plays important role as far as their relation is concerned. But it is sure that if their relations are okay, the city will definitely grow. Now, finally, I would like to add some good examples of the working of mayors and working of commissioner. There are some studies in which it has been shown that mayor, a particular mayor, certain corporations in Maharashtra, in Punjab, in Gujarat, some studies have shown that mayors on their own, with their initiative, with their participation of local people, they have directed the working of the municipal corporation towards good heights. They have carried out very useful developmental functions. We can see the condition of certain cities in Gujarat, in Maharashtra, in some other states also. And same is the case with commissioner. If the commissioner is dynamic, having good orientation towards development, having good managerial skills, he can take this city to any height. We can take the example of Ahmedabad. Ahmedabad at one particular stage, it was declared as a plague city. After earthquakes in later part of 90s, it was very difficult to raise or to come into terms with the original terms of development of the city. It was one municipal commissioner, Mr. Keshav Verma, whose work has been noted down by the in a case form in Asian Development Bank studies. He took the city with his skills to greater heights, and it is the same city which was being avoided by politicians, and it got the status, a particular status, a particular level where all the politicians of the state, they were attracted to it. What he did was, he recruited certain young CAs, young engineers, young MBAs, and he put them to a work. He took the judiciary into confidence to take up certain major demolition work in the city, and he was successful in that. Same is the case with the Surat, the commissioner there, who was a lady, and he took the city to a greater height from a dirty city, from a plague city, to one of the cleanest cities of Asia. And this designation was officially given to Surat after a few years of its demolition or its suffering with the plague. And that credit goes mainly to the commissioner. There again, we can again say that it was with the help of mayor and councillors that both these wings worked together and took the city and took the working of the municipal corporation to greater heights. So friends, with this we finish this task and hope you would have understood the significance of executive wing, deliberative wing, mayor and commissioner. Thank you.